Assalamualaikum and good evening. So now we are going to discuss about vibration analysis and monitoring in our lecture 7. Okay, generally, what is condition monitoring is all about? Condition monitoring aims actually at detecting faults to minimize production costs and optimize predictive maintenance. Dalam kata mudahnya, condition monitoring itu adalah pemantauan keadaan yang bertujuan untuk mengenal pasti kegagalan, okay, untuk mengurangkan kos pengeluaran ataupun kos operasi dan juga untuk mengoptimiskan predictive maintenance ataupun penyelenggaraan secara ramalan. So proses ini sebiasanya dia agak memenatkan kerana untuk mengesan kegagalan dia bergantung kepada geometri komponen yang terlibat. Okey, dia punya jenis dan juga tahap keseriusan kerosakan tersebut. Okey, bila melibatkan mesin, dia punya jenis-jenis mesin yang melibatkan, dia punya kelajuan, kedudukan pengesan ataupun sensor dan juga kaedah untuk membuat pemprosesan isyarat ataupun signal processing. Baik, gear. Bila kita bincangkan tentang gear, gear adalah komponen yang penting yang terlibat di dalam putaran ketika dia beroperasi dan selalunya kegagalan dalam komponen gear ini akan menyebabkan malapetaka dalam operasi di sesuatu industri tersebut. Berkenaan dengan gear condition monitoring ni, setiap mesin dia bila melibatkan gear, dia berputar. Dan bila dia berputar, dia akan menghasilkan bunyi yang spesifik. Dan bila dia menghasilkan bunyi, akan bersamanya timbulnya getaran ataupun getaran itu menghasilkan bunyi. Okey, dan bunyi ini dia ada dia punya frekuensi dia yang tertentu. Dan daripada isyarat getaran yang dipuluhi, jadi kita boleh dapat tahu keadaan sebenar struktur yang terlibat di dalam mesin itu. Jadi macam mana kaedah untuk nak mendapatkan isyarat getaran tu, yang mana ia amat berguna untuk mengetahui, okay, to mengetahui, detect, mengesan. To detect kegagalan ataupun kecacatan awal, incipient tu awal, sebelum ia menjadi critical. Jadi cerita dia, kegagalan dalam gearbox ni, boleh didiagnose, boleh dikaji, okay, bahasa mudah dia kaji menggunakan pengesanan terhadap frekuensi yang terhasil. Dan gearbox yang punya frekuensi yang tertentu tersebut, ia berkait juga dengan putaran shaft, okay, frekuensi pada putaran shaft. Okay, frekuensi pada gear mesh ataupun pertemuan gigi gear, yang mana dia terkait rapat dengan apa nama frekuensi harmonik dan juga frekuensi jalur sisi dia, side bands. Okay, gear condition monitoring ni sebenarnya dia punya teknik untuk nak mengesan atau meramal keadaan dia. Dia biasanya menggunakan kaedah analisis getaran ataupun vibration analysis. Yang paling biasa digunakan adalah menggunakan vibration analysis ataupun kaedah getaran. Dan dalam gearbox, dia mengandungi shaft, gear dan juga bearing. Jadi semua all in one. So isyarat yang diperolehi daripada pengesan getaran ataupun vibration sensor, dia mengandungi sama ada yang pertama primary rotation frequency of the gear dan juga shaft pinion dia dan juga gear pinion dia, yang di mana kedua gear dan juga pinion tu berpusing di atas shaft. Okey. Dan gabungan di antara keduanya. Seterusnya frekuensi yang terhasil disebabkan oleh sentuhan antara gigi gear, dua gear yang bersentuhan, itu gear mesh frequency, dan juga gabungannya. Okey, dan seterusnya frekuensi yang berkaitan dengan bearing. Bearing yang menampung shaft pinion dan shaft gear. Seterusnya jalur sisi gear mesh dan juga gear mesh harmonic, dan akhir sekali frekuensi yang berkaitan dengan tanda cutting ke atas ataupun macam apa tanda seolah macam ada kelaran ataupun garisan ke atas permukaan gear. Okey, yang ini juga akan menghasilkan bunyi yang rawak. Jadi untuk nak mengurangkan gearbox downtime ataupun kerosakan gear, dan juga untuk nak mengelakkan daripada performanya menurun, satu sistem pemantauan yang praktikal amat diperlukan untuk memberikan satu amaran awal jikalau kemungkinan berlakunya kerosakan ataupun kegagalan. Jadi sebelum kerosakan gearbox itu menjadi teruk, ada satu monitoring system yang praktikal diperlukan. Okey, gear condition monitoring ni sebenarnya untuk nak melihat kalau berlakunya gearbox breakdown, biasanya disebabkan oleh sama ada gigi gear tu patah ataupun dipatah disebabkan oleh apa nama dah over limit penggunaan gear tersebut terlalu lama, mungkin disebabkan oleh kepanasan ataupun disebabkan oleh pelincir yang sudah terlalu lama digunakan dan penuh dengan kekotoran yang sehingga dia tidak berfungsi lagi, sehingga menyebabkan kepanasan yang terhasil tidak dapat diserap oleh pelincir tersebut, dicampur dengan sepehan-sepehan hasil daripada gear mesh tadi, menyebabkan fatigue cracking ataupun berlakunya ada bila berlakunya gear mesh antara permukaan gear yang bersentuhan akan menyebabkan berlakunya terhasilnya lubang-lubang kecil. Jadi antara ketiga-tiga kegagalan ini, dia akan menyebabkan gigi dia menjadi tidak mantap dan akan jadi lemah, dan seterusnya menyebabkan kemungkinan untuk berlakunya gear box broken adalah amat tinggi. Dan sebenarnya dalam gear condition monitoring ini, selain daripada menggunakan kaedah analisis getaran ataupun vibration analysis, ada lagi satu kaedah untuk nak memantau keadaan gear adalah menggunakan analisis pelincir ataupun lubrication analysis yang berfokus kepada analisis sepehan, okay, di dalam pelincir. Dan biasanya di industri, untuk melakukan vibration analysis ni, dia diserahkan kepada satu tim mechanical, manakala untuk menganalisis pelincir diserahkan kepada satu tim yang fokus pada lubrication ataupun pelincir. Dan untuk nak buat gear fault diagnosis, okay, untuk nak mengkaji kegagalan gear tersebut, kalau kita menggunakan kaedah vibration analysis, dia akan dikaji dari segi spektrum frekuensi yang terhasil. Manakala kalau kita menggunakan kaedah wear debris analysis, dia akan mengkaji berdasarkan result ataupun keputusan daripada ferrograph yang fokus pada parts per million concentration. Jadi ini ada dia punya tool yang digunakan. So ada dua kaedah yang biasa digunakan untuk mengesan ataupun mengkaji kerosakan gear. Dan sebenarnya vibration monitoring ni, dia dalam gear, sebagai contoh, memerlukan kefahaman yang menyeluruh, okay, untuk nak mengenal pasti tindak balas frekuensi, okay, daripada setiap komponen all-in-one yang telah disetup tadi, yang merangkumi gear itu sendiri ataupun bearing ataupun shaft, yang mana jikalau kefahaman secara menyeluruh tidak dipenuhi, jadi keputusan yang jitu tidak sukar untuk didapatkan. Manakala kalau kata disebabkan kegagalan disebabkan oleh berlakunya timbulnya ataupun terhasilnya sepihan ataupun lubang pada permukaan gear yang melepaskan sepihan, jadi analisis wear debris adalah yang sesuai dilakukan. Okay. Untuk lebih teliti ataupun lebih faham, jadi kita rujuk ataupun kita lihat video yang disediakan ini.
We'll begin by looking at a relatively basic single reduction gearbox. Following the analysis process, the first step is to familiarize yourself with the equipment. This gearbox contains only two gears. The smaller pinion gear drives the larger gear, which turns the output shaft at a lower rate of speed than the input shaft. This particular piece of equipment operates continuously for months on end, and it has been performing smoothly, requiring no unplanned maintenance since its last shutdown. Spectral data collected just prior to the shutdown indicate that vibration levels were within specifications, and no significant parts were replaced. We are inspecting the equipment as part of the planning process for the next shutdown. The second step in our analysis process is to determine important speeds and frequencies, and the input shaft is the place to start. The shaft is turning at 1,404 rotations per minute. We can divide 1,404 by 60 and find that 1,404 rotations per minute is equal to 23.4 rotations per second, or cycles per second, or hertz. This number is the 1 times speed of the shaft. We also know that there are 30 teeth on the pinion gear, and we know that every one of them must mesh with teeth on the other gear every time the input shaft completes one rotation. If we think of each tooth meshing as an event, we know that 30 teeth and one rotation of the shaft will produce 30 events. Two rotations will produce 60 events, and so on. Therefore, we can multiply the 30 teeth times the 23.4 rotations per second at which the shaft and the pinion gear are turning and find a total of 702 events per second. In other words, the teeth on the pinion gear will mesh with the teeth of the larger gear a total of 702 times in a single second. This number is known as the gear mesh frequency. It is the number of teeth times the speed of the shaft. The gear mesh frequency is a number you must know in order to analyze vibration in any gear arrangement, so we'll look at it more closely. Again, the pinion gear has 30 teeth, and it is turning at 23.4 cycles per second, so it must produce a gear mesh frequency of 702 Hz, and any gear mated with it will also have a gear mesh frequency of 702 Hz. Since the mating gear in this case has 119 teeth, we can divide the gear mesh frequency, 702, by 119 teeth and learn that the output shaft must be turning at approximately 5.9 rotations per second, or 5.9 Hz. We have now identified the important speeds and frequencies in our gearbox. We are ready for step 3 in our 6-step analysis process. Locate the 1 times in the spectral data. The input shaft is turning at 23.4 Hz, and this is the 1 times frequency we must locate in the spectrum. We see a low amplitude peak in what appears to be the right frequency range for the 1 times. If we place the cursor on the peak, our analysis software reveals a frequency of 23.4 Hz, and we know we have located the 1 times. The amplitude of the peak is low, only about 0.02 inches per second, which is within specifications and should not be considered a problem. Our next step, step 4, is to look for signature vibration patterns, and the pattern you see here is a textbook gear signature. In addition to the peak at the 1 times frequency, which we have already identified, there is a second peak, often of greater amplitude, at the gear mesh frequency. By placing the cursor on the peak, we find a frequency of 702.43 Hz, which closely matches our calculated gear mesh frequency of 702. The amplitude of the gear mesh frequency is in the moderate range, so this is not yet a serious problem. Side bands, or peaks, on both sides of the gear mesh frequency are also typical of a gear mesh signature, and they lead us to step 5, identify other vibrations present. Side bands are the product of modulation. Low-level vibrations coming from elsewhere in the equipment are being transmitted and possibly even amplified by the strong gear mesh frequency, which tends to act as a carrier frequency. Side bands provide a visual representation of the low-level vibrations being carried along by the stronger vibration. If we were to zoom in and take a closer look at the side bands, we would find one of two possible patterns. The side bands may appear to be generally regular, which is most common, or random. In this case, they appear to be regularly spaced, so we'll measure the space between them. Using the cursor to mark the gear mesh frequency at a vertical line to mark the taller of the two closest side bands, we find a delta frequency or frequency difference of 23.4 Hz. This number should look familiar. It is the 1 times frequency of the input shaft. We now know that the gear on the input shaft, in other words, the pinion gear, is the source of the low-level vibration. Let's think for a moment. The gear mesh frequency is the number of teeth times shaft speed. Since the delta frequency between the side bands, in this case, is equal to shaft speed, we should be able to divide the gear mesh by the delta frequency and find the number of teeth on the gear with the problem. 702.43 Hz divided by 23.4 Hz equals 30.02, a number very close to the 30 teeth on the pinion gear. Now, let's suppose for a moment that the side bands have been found to be randomly spaced. There is a significant noise floor and a family of vibrations around the gear mesh, but there are no clearly defined peaks. This vibration pattern is less common, but perhaps more difficult to interpret. It could be that the gears are extremely loose and vibrating randomly, or that the gear lubricant is failing and we are seeing rub. However, you would expect to find a more severe gear mesh vibration if rub were the problem, and looseness will often generate harmonics or subharmonics of the 1 times. In this particular case, it may be that traveling frequencies coming from elsewhere, inside or possibly even outside the gearbox case, are masking the sidebands and creating the illusion of random vibration. The time domain may prove valuable. In the time domain, we find a pattern of pulses that appear to be regularly spaced. If we measure from the highest amplitude peak in one pulse to the highest amplitude peak in the next pulse, we will find a delta time or time difference of 42.97 milliseconds, which is approximately 0.043 seconds. Remember that to convert time to frequency, we simply take the reciprocal, so we divide 1 by 0.043 seconds. What we find is a frequency difference of 23.27 Hz, which closely approximates the 1 times speed of the input shaft at 23.4 Hz. Again, we have reason to believe that the vibration is coming from the pinion gear, and we may begin to suspect the presence of a minor but developing problem. We are now ready for step 6 in the analysis process. Assess the equipment and recommend corrective action. Based on the analysis we have performed, we have reason to believe that a problem is developing with the pinion gear. However, the vibration level is moderate and within acceptable limits. We know that the gears were not replaced during the last scheduled shutdown, and it's common for the gears moving at the highest speeds to show wear first, so it is likely that what we are seeing is normal wear to the pinion. As for a recommendation, the equipment is operating smoothly and another shutdown is approaching. There is no reason to shut down the equipment early. However, continue monitoring the gearbox as the scheduled shutdown approaches to be sure the problem does not worsen suddenly. During the shutdown, the gears should be inspected and lubricant evaluated. Additional data should be collected at restart.
Sekian, terima kasih.